Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the EIZO Cup. I am TobiWan, bringing your English live stream on behalf of the joinDOTA Red live stream. That's right, we have different color coordinations. That way, no one feels a little bit more special than the other, and we keep on casting out awesome games. For your viewing pleasure, EIZO Cup is what we're doing right now. In fact, let's jump ourselves here inside the game for game number two of our grand final of Kaipi going up against TTD, formerly known as EIZO Cup. They are playing with a stand-in tonight, so while there is no resolution in their team this evening, but they are still playing up against, well, I don't even want to call it, it is a stand-in, it's more of a fielding team for Kaipi, as they try and work out who their fifth player is going to be, but I'm pretty sure they can't have quite for who is their official stand-in for this evening, but we are here for the game, and I say we, because I'm joined again by the man who likes to carry casts, the capitalist.
I'm sorry, I'm a little distracted. You probably didn't notice because you were busy doing important things, but you don't have any chat mods on right now. And I took advantage of this fact and put on subscribers mode and then pimped my Twitter and Twitch. All right. Then I released it. Radiant team pick. But I thought it was pretty funny. The chat trolls me, I troll the chat back.
It's at this point we are removing his admin privileges.
No!
So capitalist cannot be trusted. He cannot.
I only did it for 2 seconds, I swear.
And I have moderators on here, man. I'm seeing a lot of moderators on here.
I don't know. I spammed, I asked, I was like, are there any moderators here? I asked that a couple times. Nobody responded, so I took advantage. Well, see, you don't need to love your chat. You need to rule your chat with an iron fist.
Nope.
They slap you, you punch them.
Nope. In fact, yep. You're even getting a timeout for that.
No.
Congratulations. Let's look at that drop, man. Let's look at that drop. You don't mess with my Twitch chat, man. You don't mess with my Twitch chat. You do not abuse the Twitch chat. You respect the Twitch chat. You give them coffee and cake in the morning. That's what you gotta do. All right, let's look at that draft, man, because right now, teams want to play with fire as well as little sparkly things. So we'll have both Whisper Nagami banned out here by Eternal Envy, the Lifestealer and the Visage being banned out by Mag. So the Whisper goes the way of Kaipi as they had first pickup. Batrider as well as SD is going to be the return pickup for that, but Kaipi get what is almost classed as the winning combination here in Europe as far as Wisp combos go. CK as well as Wisp coming their way. OD as well as the Alchemist will then be banned out, so Kaipi not going to go into this whole, let's have the battle for farm as quickly as possible. Instead, we go a different kind of route, and then you've got Alchemist, taken out, so OD also being taken out. No massive strong laners. Razor was still an opportunity there, but it looks like TTD are going to go down the lines of doing the old-fashioned combo, and a combo which actually Kaipi, especially Sing Sing's, had a lot of experience with back in the days of 1437 and Sing Sing on Mouseports. They ran this Conquer and SD combo all the time, and that'll be what comes out the way of TTD.
Yeah, you know, I really like this combo. It's a classic combo like you were talking about, but this is also, TTD is fully addressed the Wisp, I feel. Not only are they going to be able to have a nice defensive support that gives them time, disruption from Shadow Demon, they have the Batrider who is able to be a really good counter gank hero going up against the Wisp, being able to jump in, lock down the carry hero that teleports in. And then on top of that, if they kill the carry hero and they've got a second or two before Wisp teleports out, X marks the spot. He comes right back, they get an additional kill. So they have a lot of different ways to be able to deal with the Wisp. I like this. This is really smart. Now they picked up a Lone Druid, a good pusher, a good team fighter later on in the game, but also is a very tanky hero who is able to deal with Wisp combos because of the fact they try and teleport in on a Lone Druid. Not only is he tanky enough to give them time for support to come in, but the bear is usually still free to attack the Wisp. And if he gets the right root, you know, he might actually be able to buy enough time for Lone Druid to get away, or he may just get a counter kill on the Wisp. So I think TTD has done a great job addressing the fact that they were giving up Wisp, but at the same time, Kaipi, they've got a really good lineup so far. Darkseer, now the Keeper of the Light, very strong tri lane, and a lot of movement around the map now. Not only do you have the Wisp teleport out, but you have the relocate back in.
5 seconds remaining. I had nothing to add to that, man. You're very comprehensive.
Were you busy staring at the kappa in chat?
No. I have that in my side screen. It's like a peripheral bliss.
They're starting a liberate capitalist chant.
Well, yeah, you will be a liberator.
Not really, but you'll say it.
No. We don't have to liberate capitalists. The kappa has always been free, but the capitalist is obviously just riding the wave of like inappropriate admin abuse. So yeah. You gotta serve your time, man. Respect my authority. Yeah.
Very well.
But the problem I'm seeing right now, as far as TTD goes, actually, I know you're talking about like you got this combination, which is really good for dealing with like Wisp and CK when they come in, possibly for support to arrive, and so on and so forth. But I'm still looking at a huge ass team fight coming out from Kaipi, with a Darkseer, a Coddle, and then CK jumping around with tether stuns all through it as well. I'm not surprised that Mag takes out the Clockwork Goblin right now, because it would have actually been a really good mid-solo option up against the Batrider. Because mainly it's looking at also what's going to control during a team fight. I got a feeling, though, Envy is already looking at picking up a Queen of Pain in this lineup. I'm not seeing a band out unless my eyes are deceiving me. And we'll look to add an extra nuke on top of the Darkseer, the Coddle, and just add another level of maneuverability, split push. They've already got the counter push, which comes from the Keeper of the Light and the Iron Shell from Darkseer. So Lone Druid taking out towers is really going to be difficult. Getting a pick off on one person probably won't be as difficult. But yeah, at this point I'm feeling Kaipi's laning is still a lot stronger. They don't need to go into this Wisp relocate to kill everything lineup. If Wisp and CK just find levels, they can buff up that CK to a point. They can just take out that top lane. And they will take out those towers. Because what do you got for counter push? You got Batrider, Firefly, Lone Drill Bear, can pull some aggro down. They kind of need like a Rubik as their last one, so they can pull some aggro down. Envy was thinking of the leaner, thinking about another like a combiner with the SD. But right now, they need to have something that's going to stop the push, in my mind. And those options are pretty limited. And they're actually... Okay, so we're gonna go a little bit more all-in. We're going to go in for an Enchantress. To a point, you can, because you can use a creep to pull down the aggro. But this kind of feels like they want to do a lot of damage to that Tier 1 tower on that bottom lane very, very quickly. And that's going to mean that Lone Druid solo on the bottom lane, Kunk SD in the mid, and Batrider up on that top lane. Because they need that farm. They need those levels up on Lone Druid very, very quickly. And he's only going to get that when he's solo.
Yeah, you know, if Kaipi wanted to be true trolls, you're thinking about Chaos Knight being the hard carry and a tri-lane, and you're looking at a mid right here. They could also go the Chaos Knight Wisp middle and pick up a Phantom Lancer as a dual lane in the safe lane.
Oh, don't even.
But I think that you're all right, and you are. They're going to go Queen of Pain.
This cousin knows what he's talking about. This cousin knows what he's talking about. Yeah. This cousin knows what he's talking about. Oh, man. Yeah, sorry. My moment song and dance. Puyakacha. I'm feeling so good now. I'm feeling so good. I'm actually really happy that the Coddle PL didn't happen. That makes me very, very happy. And we're going to see Quiper on his Queen of Pain. But I am interested to see if TTD do run like the lanes, like I was saying. Like if they are going to commit, because we know Mag can take that long lane on the Lone Druid. In fact, Lone Druid is his hero. Out of all these players, Lone Druid is his hero. 10 seconds. And I'm interested to see if he does just decide to go long lane. If this even becomes like an aggressive tri-lane. Another option, which I didn't really consider, is if they throw the Enchantress inside the Dire Jungle with the SD, and they just search for openings up there. That could be our other like little curveball to throw.
Well, this should... I don't really put an advantage to one lineup or the other. I do think TTD, this time, I think they have a better lineup. I think that they have addressed the Wisp really well. And not only do they have the early game covered really well, but they can go into late game without too much to worry about. Because of the fact that Kaipi went for a Queen of Pain. Queen of Pain does go into late game better. And she does have a Scythe of Ice that she can pick up. And even sometimes go into some physical damage. or go in refresher and just max out your magical damage. Either way, she goes in the late game and still has is decently strong. But going up against a Kunkka, a Lone Druid, and a Batrider, late game is pretty pretty well assured by TTD. Even supports like Shadow Demon and Enchantress are very, very strong. So Kaipi's really good. The pressure is on them this game, I feel, to focus on the mid game. Even though they do have the Wisp Chaos Knight, this game isn't assured for them. They don't have the strongest of lanes. If they're going to go for a defensive trend lane, they're not going to be able to put a whole lot of pressure on TTD. And you're going to see TTD get really really greedy in this laning phase. They're going to focus on using the jungle to max effectiveness with Enchantress and Batrider. Kunkka should do very well in middle. In fact, we're doing a Lone Druid tri-lane? What are we doing here? Oh, is it Lone Druid offlane, Batrider mid, and a Kunkka tri-lane? That's what it is. Never mind.
I'm done. What?
Thanks.
What?
Thanks, Tobe.
I was really trying to follow you on that one. I'm just like, I got lost.
What are TTD's lanes is what I was discussing.
Mag solo bottom lane, Enchantress in the jungle, SD Kunkka mid, crazy long lane. Mm-hmm. That's my call on this, and I'm calling that because I want to see him do damage to the bottom tower quickly, and mag needs levels for that. That's the reason why I'm calling that. Their other option is it is just mag, long lane, crazy mid, and then it's Jackal, SD, Enchantress in the bottom lane, looking for kills and just forcing down the towers with just the Enchantress pushing power, and maybe they could find themselves a kill. That for me is their only two major options.
Yeah, you know, I actually like your idea of the SD Kunkka mid, just because the Batrider, he's not the extremely strong versus Queen of Pain because of the slow poison sting.
Yep.
Also really good attack animation by Quap. But the Shadow Demon Kunkka combo is extremely strong against her. So
yeah, the only thing is that perfect timing of like the disruption into the torrent. That's gonna be perfect between Fly and Jackal. But luckily, those two guys have been playing with each other for such a long time. They're doing that kind of combination. It should almost be like second nature to them. So I would feel that they have enough combination between the pair that they could actually do that.
No.
Sorry, I'm just checking what the reason is for the delay, because someone says, yeah, nothing has been said at all. And I got a feeling the admin's fallen asleep.
Pause. Resume. Pause.
Yeah, I got a feeling the admin has fallen asleep as well. So, we'll find out what the GO is. Okay. Wow, I just read that as IFK. Okay, no, he's back. So, we're good to go. See? Say something. It'll always happen. It's like, let's go to a break. Instantly, game gets unpaused. Always happens. Always bloody happens. All right. Let's see if I'm right. Let's see if I'm right about the lanes. Jackal's already built for bottle. And I'm going to extra turn of tangos on him as well. They may all just head down towards the bottom lane to start with. And in fact, that looks like where everybody is going right now. But judging by Mag's items, like he's already got a tango and a healing salve. He looks prepared to go up against Darkseer solo. And as far as Kaipi goes, standing lanes for them. CK Wisp up on the top. Nothing would ever really question that. Pylar die as the coddle. Will we just be stacking and farming in the jungle? Might be helping out Bone 7 here and there if Bone 7 doesn't want to go down to the walls that bottom lane. And that leaves Queen of Pain to solo up the middle lane, and they'll be taken up by Koitva.
Yeah, we're just still waiting on, it does look like we're going to have the Lone Druid in the safe lane. And they're really going to have to use their jungle well. They're going to have to really focus on stacking when you have double junglers like this. You can't really miss stacks. Because both Enchantress and Batrider want to be able to stack a hard camp, and then Enchantress wants to farm it using tornadoes, and then of course Batrider obviously stacks and uses Sticky Napalm to farm it. So they're going to gimp themselves a little bit, but for the most part, they won't interfere with each other too much.
So you think Batrider will remain here and just try and do these two camps right now?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, he can't run up against the Chaos Wisp combo.
True. Because then he's basically dead. Unless he can get to the very, very edge of the map, he's going to die there.
Yeah.
Quick dewarding in that middle lane. Pylai Dai does not want to give TTD any kind of advantage in that middle lane. And they needed that ward too. Because that ward helps them set up and know if they can do that disruption into the torrent. If not, they can't see above this line. So all Queen of Pain's got to do is just sit on the edge of that line. Even Coddle saying hello. Like, he's going to give a little bit of a helping hand here. I'm not actually a massive fan of this because it's not really required. Because especially when this kind of stuff happens, it damages down Jackal. Maybe this is just so they delay the bottle. If they delay the bottle of the Conker, that could be the main thing here. Because that bottle jumps back and forth. So disruption and blink doesn't happen in time. So easy damage. Down to 167 life points. There's that combination you get worried about.
Yep. That's definitely going to make Koifa have to worry a little bit. Like you said, the Keeper of Light doesn't provide anything. All he does is take away some of the experience. He's not much of a threat to be able to keep them from trying the combo. Just the damage from the Illuminate isn't going to, you know, keep Shadow Demon back. So he just needs to play really, really careful in this lane and just remember the fact that they have a complete free lane at top. Pilot Eye, he does have Keeper Light, very strong support that is able to jungle really well, especially once he hits level 3. So that's the going to be the main focus for him. In fact, he already farmed out the easy camp and is now level 2.
Sorry. I'm semi dying right now. Both of the TI3 plague, but also because like the captains have been released.
Yes, I saw that. Your chat was very angry about slow mode.
Yes.
Was it me? Was it
I gotta say it's Ryan.
Just man, to point that out.
Now these Illumas are being really, really effective. That's a 2-point scream. Fly is gonna be so careful coming in close like that. You get hit by an Illuma like that, look at the consumables already burnt through. This bottle is going to be working overtime for both support as well as core in this middle lane. Illusion. We just took even snipes out the illusion room from Koitvas. That's going to frustrate him up a little bit. Is he looking to chase this? He is. He is. He comes in. He goes for the screen because Bone 7 was coming in through the front. And now Pylai die. There's no mana for an Illuminate here. But Koitva, well, I'm not quite sure if that was really intentional. No, it wasn't. And oh wait. Big bad move. Disruption, he's got blink with a catcher, and there's 2 poison stacks, 3 poison stacks, he's got him!
Oh no!
So close. Almost a professional player. And this Chen creep, Enchanter's creep, he was trying to look to follow up with this damage, and Koifa, I'm not quite sure if he can really win up against that Dark Troll. He has to blink himself away. Well,
Koifa, why you lose 1v1?
That was an unexpected adventure.
Yes, that was. And no kills yet.
No kills yet. I even love the fact, like, the worst creep you could have found. Like the Mud Golems. The worst possible creep that Quop could have run into. Because he can't even scream his way through them.
I don't know about that. If he had gotten double centaur camps, he would have been dead. What, is he going to scream and instantly kill all the centaurs?
True.
No, that would just make them angrier.
Well, at least they wouldn't stomp him. Until they came up to him when he got disrupted. Then 3 targets in 1 area. Stomp, easy, instant kill. The trade-off right now is to make the Pylai die is finding experience in the mid. And Koifa actually just did, he failed the stack. He failed the sack, but they got a triple stack around the corner there. Oh, fly. Haste rune. Disruption. Catcher. And now, blink. Got to get himself away. There's help by Pylai die, and Koitva will blink himself away. Oh, wow. Really? Come on! That's the first blood I've missed in, like, all of these 2 days.
That's because you thought Queen of Pain was going to die.
Yep.
Good work, TTD. Like this.
Hate
Make
you.
Make Toby angry.
Hate you. Hate you.
Well, TTD is doing really well. They got that gank off there because of the troll and snare on the Darkseer. They're setting themselves up to be able to push in that bottom tower really, really early. They're not taking a huge loss from the Batrider sitting in the jungle, but with the Enchantress as well. So even though Batrider isn't allowed to take advantage of those 3 camps where he can just go from 1 to 1 to 1, he's not able to take advantage of that because the Enchantress, they're still doing a really good job making the most out of the hard camps. So they're still getting some really good levels. And Koifa, I mean, he has to play extremely careful. He's sitting at 10-1 for CS compared to Kunkka's 26-6.
Yeah, Koifa's been shut down in the mid completely. And they've got to get even more concerned about what's happening with Mag on that bottom lane. He's now level 6 on this bottom lane, and he's building into a hand of Midas. The recipe's flying out right now. I was wondering with a large amount of gold he had if he was really thinking about going in for the Radiance, but the timing would be too late for him. As far as like the Radiance effectiveness, it wouldn't have been right for him.
Yeah.
So he goes with the hand of Midas instead. Can pick it up from the side shop after like one more creep hit. If he doesn't keep taking all this damage from the Keeper of the Light.
Well, Pilot Dai has to be careful here. I mean, he has to remember that both the Enchantress and the Batrider are in the jungle. Either one of them catches him when he's trying to push out aggressively like that, and that's going to be an easy kill, and that's going to sort of reset all of the experience he picked up just by feeding away more gold. Mm-hmm. So, Batrider is now, when Enchantress is moving around the jungle a little bit more, and looks like Batrider is going to be allowed to farm that three camp area. He's working towards his Blink Dagger as soon as possible. He's not even attempting to go bottom and try and pick off Pilot Eye.
Alright. Too busy in the farm, man. Blink Dagger or go home.
No.
Bone 7 just not really having a great time here in the mid. Gets his creeps destroyed almost instantly. We still got one Iron Shell that's surviving here in the middle lane. Doing some considerable damage to Always Wanna Fly. He went from full life down to half life. But Bone 7 at least got a little bit of experience from that jungle. But then again, so did Queen of Pain. I don't know if you saw it, but the Iron Shell was left behind. And Queen of Pain just came in, screened up a little bit of it, and then took all the remaining experience from that hard camp. That all belonged to Koitva. So he's now hitting up to level 6.5. And that's his advantage. Like, Kunkka's getting some really good CS in that middle lane. But you've got the burst damage levels that's coming out from a Queen of Pain. She's back to the jungle again. They just completely abandoned this middle lane. They want her to have the 4 points up in the Scream and 1 point up in the ultimate. And Pilot, is he actually really juking this out? No, there's your enchant. They need a bear entangle. He's going to cut through the tree line again. There's a troll trap around the corner. Then your first entangler. Now he will go down. Quick Illuminate before death.
But did you see his item pickup? He went for the Quelling Blade and then cut his way through the trees. If he hadn't showed up there, I bet TTD would have just given up and assumed he teleported out.
So he did that path Raiden's right there. Top tower is
under attack. That was almost an epic juke. Almost. Well, you're about to see Jackal be level 6. That means Koifa is in the kill radius at all times. If he gets caught out by the disruption, all it takes is a simple torrent land combined with a boat, combined with the Tidebringer.
Yep.
And he's dead.
And it can all come at a big surprise too. Invis Rune just gets taken on the top lane by Kunkka. And there's so many different things that could just fly his way without him knowing. And Koifa, he got spotted by the Radiant Observer Ward. Tier 1 tower in the bottom lane will go down. This is why I'm really enjoying this lineup in the bottom lane. It doesn't need more than a lone druid or an enchantress just to kill off these towers. The timing and the push is perfect. And then, where's Balti? Hello to level 6. Enchantress dead very, very quickly. And that's the first kill that Kaipi will get to claim. Even just giving the chakra while they're down here in the bottom lane and Jackal. No X marked a spot. He might be looking to kill off Pylai Dai, but just buys his phase boots instead. Invis Rune. Does he go for it, Pylai Dai? Well, he just bumped an invisible wall, so unless he's playing Mime, I'm pretty sure he knows someone else is there. And the bear won't catch up in time. No X marked a spot. Got to hit this torrent right. And now he's going to guess it in the torrent. Pylai Dai. Wow. Entangle into the torrent. It's basically rooted and wetted and horsed.
That's the first time I've seen the whale torrent too.
Oh really?
It
freaked me out.
Yeah, it
freaked me out the first time I saw it.
It came out, so.
Poor Cap.
I know. I didn't even know what my item I got. Anyway, Koifa's gonna be able to get aggressive here, but he has to back up soon. Here comes
Destruction
Jackal.
Mid. Torrent, it's gonna hit as well. Blink, 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 blink! Away from the ship. The ship was just a second too late, and Bone 7, well, he throws down the wall, and maybe they turn to fight this one. No, he doesn't have mana for it. And in fact, the poison from Shadow Demon will get the kill, but Bone 7 with the Iron Shell, as well as copies of himself, there goes your Whale Torrent. But Jackal, he guessed he would run up high and chase it down, but SD turned around, and Bone 7 went with him. Also, we just sick. He's a long way behind enemy lines here.
That's another one. Bottom.
Wisp ulti into the tether. Support won't get there in time. 3 seconds on the stun.
Easy.
And what's... Oh, wow. That actually has a lot more, that has bigger ramifications than you originally think.
Did he lost bear? He lost bear.
He lost bear. Not only did he look like, it wasn't the bear getting killed off, it's the fact that the bear has gone cooldown. There's a resummon time now of 92 seconds and he respawns in 18 seconds. Blink, they go up and crazy. So they're going again here on Koidva. Blinding Light, trying to make this a little bit more difficult. He couldn't blink in time. In fact, he actually had to blink towards the Radiant side to escape that because he had to turn to blink just then. So it still becomes a one-for-one trade, but bear down for another 75 seconds. Kind of worth
they're
it for Kaipi.
They're going to grab Pilot Eye too. Enchantress is coming in from behind with the double damage.
Is he going to recall some help? No, there goes his ulti wearing off. Double TPs are on the way though, and that's going to be CK. Is there a Chaos Bolt? Yeah, there is. 2 seconds on the stun. Tether around the corner. Hasn't got the proper stun out in that one, so Wisp will take the kill. Going to stay away from that poison. And that was just normal TPs coming in from both Sting as well as Envy. But the armlet going to work already.
Yeah, you know, if Jackal had actually fought that, he probably would have gotten at least one kill. Chaos Knight was pretty low. He was depending heavily on armlet, and they were also in range of Shadow Demon being able to throw some Shadow Poisons down. So the moment Chaos Knight attempted to armlet toggle, that could have been a poison kill. So, but he backed up. He wanted to play safe. They know they're still trading decently well versus these Wisp ganks. They know they're going to get picked off by them, but they're still trading kills relatively well. It's just that when Wisp first hits level 6, you're pretty much guaranteed some free kills. You just cannot rotate and set up counter ganks early enough because you're too busy trying to get your basic items before that point. So it's just the inevitable fact that you're going to get picked off once or twice.
There's a sentry ward. Just watching the observer ward get dewarded by the creep wave that was coming in. I'm like, where the hell is that coming from? And I realized the two sentry wards from Kaipi are watching those exact spots. Are they having a bit of a jump? Of course they are. There goes SD.
At the same time, it's a support for support. If
Jackal No, he's not going to get it. There's a little bit of time. 4 seconds on the stun. In fact, Pylite die, the Illuminant. You could see that Wisp wasn't quite sure if that was going to work. So we just let Eternal Envy stay there if there was going to be enough time. But with that long stun from Envy, now it's 2-0 in the trade to Kaipi.
Yeah, that was bad. If he had been able to land the Torrent, he might have been able to kill the Keeper of Light. Or if it had just been a 2 seconds.
Blink Lasso, Queen of Pain, nice. Locked in, and is going to blink away. The attack actually disjointed that Impetus. She can't blink again. Is going to scream to ulti. Nope, just screams and accepts death. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, we've already got Eternal Envy and Sing Sing running in behind the tower. They're searching for Jackal. Reality Rift is going to be too far away. Bone Surfer needed to surge up somebody there, but he couldn't get it in time. And we just sick. Oh, Rift! Got him in range. 4 seconds on the stun again here from Eternal Envy. RNG gods are loving him tonight. And he goes 7-7. I say that now, and now he'll get entangled like first hit next time he sees Lone Druid.
Yeah. Still, Mag's getting some decent farm. He's going to be able to pick up a Radiance soon. He's about 1,000 gold away from the Relic.
He is going to go for that?
I think so.
I'm really surprised by this. I really thought he'd be looking to be a little bit more aggressive. Like, look towards if he's looking for a push, like go for that Maelstrom, but look to get the Basher up nice and early on.
Well, he still could, but just the fact that he's holding so much gold, what he might be planning on doing here is trying to Radiance push a lot. That way he's not putting any heroes in danger by split pushing.
The only issue is he'll start losing his bear though.
Yeah,
and that's, so that's
he has to keep good eye on it.
Yeah, but see, you got Radiance early on. This one, what I'm talking about as far as the timing of Kaipi. Kaipi's timing is perfect around like that 20 minute mark. Even right now, like CK and Wisp, they can pick off anybody they want to. But when that level 2 ultimate comes up for the Queen of Pain, when that mech is finally finished up on somebody, because I realized both Darkseer as well as Connell hadn't even started it. But once that comes up as well, Darkseer is already up at level 11, so we needed his level 12. He's progressing through those levels a lot faster. In fact, he's starting up on the mech. But once he's finished up that mech, once he's got that level 12, Kaipi will be unstoppable. In fact, this is going to even be before 22 minutes. This is going to be like 18 minutes in, and Kaipi will be at a point where I don't see TTD able to take the battle. And having something like a Radiance wouldn't do the job. And in fact, what have you already got purchased up? He bought it. He bought the Relic. There's no Blink Dagger heroes either. Like, there's no one he's going to be cancelling off, like, Blinks in. Small harassment damage. It's already going to be repaired by a lot of different heroes. And now middle lane, 3 seconds on the stun. Disruption will save a little bit of time. Envy's going to get a stun, but Jackal, just the Illumina, destroys him. Envy's got to get himself away from this. Oh, he says, no, let's go deeper. Looks at what he just sick. The Flame Break pushing him back out again. That turn rate's an absolute pain in the ass, but Koiva just jumps in, lets off a quick scream. And with the Phantasm level 2, they will take this tier 1 tower in mid.
Yeah, this is problematic because now Kaipi is grouping up. They're pushing down towers, and that's really going to hurt Mag. That being said, when they get into some of these team fights at the tier 2s and they're trying to defend, you do also have to include Kunkka's Ghost Ship. That 50% damage reduction is going to allow the team fight to go much longer than Kaipi normally would be able to plan for, because they have a lot of burst, but a 50% damage reduction is pretty big, and that's going to allow that Radiance to really come into play. As the team fight goes longer and longer, the Radiance becomes more and more effective. So, I don't know, it's just something to think about. I'm not sure if I completely agree with it either, but Mag is planning a little bit more for the late game. He thinks that they can hold this relatively well, and I think a big part of that is Shadowblade Kunkka. Shadowblade Kunkka being able to wipe through some of these creep waves and just back some of these enemies off, combined with the Ghost Ship, they have a good chance of being able to turtle for a decent amount of time.
Yeah. Let's just see how it all unfolds then. Because I'm still feeling like the turtle requires bear to have life points and some kind of presence, and no one's fearing the bear right now. Like, it's got a relic up on it. Who gives a crap? CK is walking around on his way to a heart. And this is what Eternal Envy loves to do on the CK. You have a Radiance, you're going to burn through a minimal amount of his life points, and he's just going to go straight into that fight. Like, you can lasso him, you can ship him, you can taunt him, you can do everything to him, and you'll probably bring him close to death. But you'll never get him fully down once he has that heart up and running. And at this rate, if the kills come in at the same rate they're doing so, then we'll be looking at that heart being completed by latest 25 minutes. Maybe even sooner for him. And are they thinking about Roshan? Sing Sing's in the neighborhood, but he's not quite sure about it yet. They're looking for a target. And the aggressive Dire Wards, they're looking around a little bit. They've got one that's watching up towards the ancient area, and one that's watching the top lane. So they're looking for just those heroes that head a little bit further north, just by themselves. But they will be taking Roshan now.
Yeah, this is a nice time. Because they know that there's not going to be a good chance of TTD being able to defend it. They may try for it here, but
Enchantress being a dick. Threw in the Satter. The Meg Charge already has to pop off here from Bone 7. And the Blinding Light tried to push him back, but in comes Eternal Envy. Phantasm goes off. Fly will disrupt himself up. Bone 7 back into that wall. He's doing everything he can before he goes down right now. And nope, he is the only one to be dead. Soon to be Wisp as well. So two heroes lost. Enchantress, the Chasers there. And Koitva able to get that scream up. But Eternal Envy, there's that entangle on him. Armlet toggling. 6-1 charges not being used. And Koitva actually ticking down right now. And that's why Sticky Napalm lets up a scream. But they're too far away. And that Radiance Burn. Whoa! Blink away. Bottle charges up. 3-3. It's 2-3. 1 charges up his sleeve. But that was a 3-2. And two of those heroes that Kaipi lost were cores.
Yeah, that was pretty bad there. I was a little bit surprised that fight went well enough in the beginning, because they didn't have Mag at all. He had to teleport to the tier 2 tower in the beginning of that fight and run over, but they're able to last long enough and actually were already winning the team fight before he even got in there. So that was just a really good play. Small plays like always want to fly with the Great Disruption. Oh, and they still get him! Queen of Pain! I thought Koifa had teleported out.
No, he didn't.
I figured he had jumped down and he just was going to blink into the jungle and teleport away.
He was walking around the Radiant Jungle and never actually did the TP.
What was he looking for?
The meaning of life?
I guess so.
Well, not found. The Eternal Quest. But that is just... yeah. Kaipi's going to pull their heads in. If Kaipi want to take this 2-0 and actually claim and be the only team to have claimed 3 titles from the EIZO Cup, they have to, like, stop playing Game of Throws. They had a 6,000 experience advantage. Now this is coming back to 2,500, and the gold advantage only just above 1,000 their way. And this Radiant Spear now works. Because it's got time. It's got time to actually get items up on it that... you can actually get life on the bear. You can get life on yourself. And Kaipi cannot deal with it now. They've actually missed their sweet timing because they've given so much to TTD that they've caught up to where they need to be. Like, 4-star for Batrider. Now only about 250 gold away from being completed. These key items are arriving. Medallion of Courage for the SD. Just gonna fly out in the courier. We just sick as 4 earn charges and double braces. So looking nice for that one. And the Shadow Blade is done for the Kunkka now. So with the Shadow Blade, his own bracer, maybe looking in towards drums. He can do a lot more damage to Kaipi. Not maximum just yet, but it's still a really decent amount of damage.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if Eternal Envy is going to hold on to this, because he's already got Armlet, and right now a Vitality Booster. I'm not sure if he's actually going to hold on and just make it a naked Vit Booster, or if he's fully committing to Heart at this point in time. But the biggest thing for him is getting to level 16. So they're going to attempt Roshan once again and give up that tier 1 tower at top. If they can, once the moment they get level 16, they have to just go in. Because that's where Chaos Knight really get extremely strong with an extra level in Phantasm. That's a large upgrade to your damage. You've already got a significant amount of tank that they can't burst through a lot of those illusions very quickly. And they really need to put a stop to this bear before he gets too big. With his Radiance is already helping out a lot. He gets an Assault Cuirass. That bear's going to be hitting very, very hard.
And Koyva's going to bail out right now. I don't know if you saw the mass TPs. There was 4 of them. 2 that went to the bottom, 2 that went to the mid. I really thought they're going to make a beeline for the Rosh Pit, but they would have only just made it in time if they ran directly there, but they didn't. That Queen of Pain was too much of a distraction in the bottom lane. But,
One whack. Very well. Very well.
At least it's better than the Swedish joke. It's just like, 1 sec. Wait, their currency is sec. Oh, insert weird joke here. Have you never fallen victim to that?
No, I have never fallen victim to that at all.
You need to cast more Swedish teams. They all spell sec as in S-E-K. Which is their currency there. You should actually see, like with all the different countries I've been traveling to of late, I got like a little bag at home, and it's got like the currencies from the different places around, like, yeah, different currencies countries from around the world. So if I ever go back to China, like I've got like 800 yen just sitting there waiting to be used. Same with Malaysia, I got like the Malaysian ringgit. And then the monopoly money of Ukraine, because it looks like monopoly money. Yeah,
it does.
And then
you're
again,
such a worldly
then
man,
again,
Toby.
Yes, I well traveled. But the worst thing is actually the new euro. That looks like monopoly money as well. Like, it looks really bad. The old euro had some class to it. The new euro.
Are they?
They changed it, man. They changed it. I don't like change. I hate change. I'm an old man. I sit on my front porch and say, that grass doesn't cut the same way.
Grr. Get off my lawn.
Is that your Clint Eastwood?
Well, no, that was not my Clint Eastwood. That was a Clint Eastwood quote, but not my Clint Eastwood impersonation. By the way, it looks like they're going for double Scythe of Ice. Queen of Pain, pretty normal pick up for her, but Darkseer looks like to also be going that. If they could pick up a Halberd, that would be really useful against the bear. But again, I think they just need to finish up that farm. Tooth of Scythe of Ice, Chaos Knight go for his next item, whether that's a Halberd, whether that's a heart, I don't really care one way or the other. Just, if they get that, they get hit until level 16, they just go all out. The bad thing is they still have a lot of tier 2s to crack through. TTD is not that bit far behind in farm. They need to have a significant gold lead going into these fights. And they have not been able to use the Wisp to be able to just dominate TTD.
No.
They played very, very passive. They used their jungle very, very well. Like, this Batrider has hardly moved away from his jungle at all, and he's sitting at Plink Dagger and 4-staff.
Well, we kind of knew this was going to be the effect of the Wisp. Like, we knew this was going to happen.
Yeah.
You get a Wisp. I was actually really surprised they got as many early kills as they did. And that was because TTD was out of position multiple times. And Kaipi, they instantly just like jumped on it. They knew how to make the most out of that. So now you've got to work harder and just use the Wisp as a buff. And the Wisp is a big-ass buff. He can keep Quap alive, he can keep that CK really, really strong. Like, all these different things together. And Eternal Envy just needs time now, because he does have the 3300. So that's his Reaver if he wants it.
Yeah.
And that's then going to make it very difficult for TTD to kill him off in the fight. I say that now, but you got Radiance and the Assault Cuirass is definitely well on its way. And with these two different things combining up together, CK's armor is going to be so minimal it's not funny. Mm-hmm. He kind of needs something of his own just to be there. Even if it just becomes like a casual plate mail, which at some later point he'll turn into an AC. And we got Darkseer. Interesting move from Bone 7. He's going straight into Refresher. He's already got the Perseverance up on himself, unless he's looking at a Lincoln Sphere. Which may be another option when you get a Bat Rider on the field. And did you just, like, strangle a cat?
That's the sound of, I don't know how I feel about that.
As in, straight Refresher or Lincoln Sphere?
Both. But Lincoln Sphere, I think, is the better choice, just because he needs to make sure he does get off his full wall vacuum. So if he's jumped on by the Bat Rider, that could really mess with their team fight. Because he also has the mech. So that makes him double, like a double target, pretty much. Because they not only is he kind of squishy because he has a mech, if they're able to grab him, pull him back, and kill him before he is the disables go away, not only do they take away a lot of their team fight with the mech, but they also take away the vacuum, wall, everything else. So he's a high priority target. I was thinking more disables. But it's not a bad idea going for Lincoln's.
Envy has his heart. Wait. Corey's coming in too soon. Okay, so Envy doesn't have his heart. In fact, if they're really deciding to group up right now for a smoke gank, this is the worst possible timing they could think of. It's 1100 for a heart recipe, isn't it? Unless I'm tripping. 1200. Okay, so we are still short. Do they ever change that? Do they increase the cost of it? Nah.
No, but I make the same mistake, and I believe... move, stupid. Oh my god. I can't see what I want to look at. That's why, because you're thinking about the other big strength item that goes with Reaver, which is an 1100 recipe, Satanic.
Of course!
I get that mixed up all the time, too.
Of course. Yeah. Well, one thing to add to those memory banks. But that heart, man, look how quickly CK just buffs up his life points. And then turns on the armlet, and you got 3k life points now to get through. Kunkka doesn't have this damage yet. He's going BKB next. I'm wondering if just actually picking up a Chrysalis before the BKB, so they get that real big initiation damage, would have been worth it. Then let the bear mop up the rest of it with the Batrider.
Yeah, possibly. Unfortunately, won't be enough damage to kill the illusions now, but it's the right idea. Chaos Knight, if he gets a Halberd next, I think that would be a really smart idea. He'd be able to disable the bear while also being able to give himself even more tank. The evasion, obviously, is going to be very good versus the bear, as well as the Kunkka. So.
Got a short amount of time left. Blink, Scream, crazy. Sting, 4-star, Pylite Die. Actually putting the Mana Leak on and backing him back. He's been pummeled around here, crazy. And, wonderful forced up. Evasive damage, there needs to be a back. There's a wall, they can see him, but they can't kill him. Commitment galore to kill him off.
Wow, that's really bad. I don't think Kaipi was looking to push into the base yet anyway, but it does just delay. They cannot force a fight, obviously, while that's down.
Yep. That was such heavy commitment. Such heavy commitment. They must have thought he was a little bit lower than he really was as well when that Darkseer wall went down, or in the fact he just didn't have a TP scroll, but this was Batrider, he had a TP, definitely. He was so far up, if he didn't have a TP, you could slap him silly. But now Lincoln's Fear was Lincoln's Fear for the Darkseer. He has completed it up. And just needs a little bit more time before he hits that level 16. So a level 3 wall will be available in just under a minute. Corpaldi comes back in just under a minute and a half. In the meantime, Envy's just finding his farm for buyback gold.
Mm-hmm.
and Sing Sing. I mean, Sing Sing. I'm used to Sing 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 playing Kunkka. Jackal up on that Kunkka. He does pick up the BKB. I'm still feeling, though, that if he gets stunned up before that even happens, even if he doesn't, if the Phantasm Illusions get close enough, they will just destroy that Kunkka. 1,700 life points for... Well, actually, they're still in level 2. They're still in level 2 in the Phantasm. But once that level gets to level 3, then Kunkka will just disintegrate. Anybody that is focused on by the CK will just die so quickly.
Yeah.
Well, Kaipi gonna try and fight this? Yeah, they are. Darkseer was dragged in. He's got level 3 ulti up and running. Surging himself in. Tried to go for the back. Couldn't catch anybody up. And there's Mag. How long on the stun? Phantasm goes up. And now the trigger of Lincoln Sphere on Bone 70. Luna will fly, but already the Darkseer goes down. But Mag, well, all of TTD are fighting inside the wall. Blink Lasso, they're holding Envy in position. That armlet, as well as that heart, really going hard work here. He's backing himself up. They've still lost two. And now the Impetus, while X marks spot, drags it back in again. Mag with the double kill now. And this is a huge opening. This is a big, big opening. Buyback is actually available for Eternal Envy, and he needs to do it, or else they lose this bottom tier 3 tower and possibly Rax. Mag's gonna resummon that bear, and they find even Koifa hanging in the tree line, pushing the Keeper of the Light back. Yeah, they've got bottom Rax. They're giving it up.
This might even be game, because now they're gonna go for a second set of Rax. They may back up.
They can't. The tier 2 tower's still up.
Oh well. They still have really strong late game. And the fact that they just cleaved through that Chaos Knight, I think Kaipi just was never able to assert enough control onto the map and never keep TTD down from being able to farm. Now, they still have a chance at a comeback here. They still have a really strong team fight, but you saw the way Chaos Knight blew his Phantasm. I think they did a poor job initiating that fight. I think they needed to use Relocate to get behind TTD and just make that chaos factor of being able to hit, you know, the Link tether stun on a lot of heroes and being able to just surround them really quickly cause a lot of confusion. You don't know where to cast the a lot of your abilities. So, but still, they were able to clear through those Phantasms really, really quickly.
Agreed. This is, Kaipi's positioning needs a little bit of rework before the next fight. But if they get the positioning right, then team fight can definitely go their way. But, again, they just lost even more than what they had before. Like I look at Lone Druid right now, whose bear is pushing out the top lane. There's a basher that awaits him. In fact, Mag can now transfer it over. And this is that power of the bear, which just cannot be contested. Once those entangles come up, it's very, very difficult to fight. And Bone 7 got locked down completely. Like, he got his Linkosphere triggered. He was entangled up. He could not move. He threw down the wall, but there was no straight-up combo. Like you're talking about the Wisp and CK coming in for the Chaos Factor. You didn't get the Darkseer back into the Quap ulti with the Illuminate either.
Yeah.
All these things were missing from the fight from Kaipi. With them, they could have destroyed TTD. Because they are still very, very weak. But they're getting stronger, especially with that fight now. Chrysalis is up on the Kunkka. Lone Druid's getting fatter. Enchantress is building into the mech, and in fact is only a headdress away from it, and has the 4 levels up in the Nature's Attendant, so has some really good consistent heal for her team as well. She'll drop off in effectiveness, but then again... I can't say really Wisp drops off in effectiveness. As long as he keeps Eternal Envy buffed, it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
But they are looking to jump.
He's still got levels of overcharge to get, so...
That's true, we got 3 of those left. Look at TTD. They are not moving away from being 5. Or if they do, they're only doing it when they know they have no observer wards watching them. And the pings are coming to defend the top tower. Is that to attack the tier 2 tower on top? Bone 7's on his way. The Illuminate push might even be enough just to kill off this tower. But TTD don't want to come up here. Not unless they know they're going to be able to take a fight, because it's going to be a waste of smoke for them. Yeah, in comes the bear. So it'll take the aggro, but with the Queen of Pain here as well, the tower is most definitely going. And they're using Mag as bait in the mid. And Kaipi are not falling for it. There's that AC.
Right idea, though.
Yeah, there's that AC I was talking about for CK. Plate mail for now. So he's going to get even harder to kill off again.
Well, TTD know they are in control of this game. All they have to do is slowly push. If Kaipi wants to do a base race here, honestly, they have the bear. They have Assault Kuras. They could push faster. I'm a little bit surprised they don't go for it and just go all in mid. But Roshan's back up, that's why.
Yep. Back it up. Claim the Aegis. Kaipi don't have base breakers. So they don't have to worry about the tier 3 tower going down. There's still fortification available for the Radiant side as well. So they got a lot of extra like safety measures in place. They don't have to worry about the push from Kaipi. But this is the same thing that Kaipi had during game 1. Like, I know I messaged Sing Sing after the end of game number 1. I'm like, hey man, like when you pick a lineup that's like, that's just basically fight winners, but no base breakers, you have to farm until 40 minutes before you can actually break the base. The only base pushes we have from Kaipi is actually the Phantasm of Chaos Knight. Pushes bloody hard and bloody fast, but it's nowhere near as consistent as strong. Oh, Pilei Dai. You confident man. But it's nowhere near as consistent as what an Enchantress and a Lone Draw bring to the fight.
Yeah.
Especially now that Lone Druid does pick up a BKB. I don't know if that's meant to be for himself or for his bear. He throws it on himself for now.
Interesting. I mean, honestly, it's not a bad idea. If you're dealing with a lot of disables going up, because the bear is your main source of damage. You want it to be free to be able to chase down some of these heroes and make sure it's not halberded up and disabled and stunned.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. I just honestly think that TTD is just slowly outplaying Kaipi. Through every stage of this game, they've made sure they've addressed the Wisp in the drafting phase. They have never been... They've got caught out sometimes, but never enough to lose them the game. And now they're just slowly taking away Kaipi's control of the map and eventually setting themselves up for a final GG push.
Mm-hmm.
They're just waiting for Kaipi to make the mistake of trying to teleport and get a pickoff. Because Kaipi's got to be feeling a little bit desperate. They know they can't outpush TTD, and they're having no luck at being able to gank them. Their team fight is going to eventually start losing. I still think that they have the stronger team fight right now. If they execute it correctly, just last time they had really bad execution problems.
Yeah. They try to fight outside the base in a narrow corridor, which didn't end up working when Darkseer got his hit off, so his wall off, so yeah. Next time. And the next time might be already now. Pilei is trying to defend. The bear goes to the high ground, missing a lot because obviously the mischance comes from the blinding light. And a second illuminate means they lose out on basically all of the It's amazing how well mana leak works on a hero who has no mana. AKA bear. Yeah, this tower is just going to be slowly whittled down. This can become the siege from TTD. That's exactly what it should be. But this is also when Kaipi, they're going to wait for TTD to push to the right of this line. And when that happens, Wisp ulti in through here. Pick off the supporters at the back. Heroes like Batrider, who are already looking for initiation. We just sick. Get rid of him, you get rid of that heal, and then they've got a chance of taking this fight. But until then, the chances are very, very low. And Darkseid's already too far away. Blink in last two, they've got Eternal Envy. The Tether is up trying to keep him in, but the ship's going to fly in. Hits on Sing Sing as well, and now Eternal Envy, well, he's going to buy back. There's no other option. If they lose two Raxes right now, this is over. But
yep.
I think he's going to call it anyway, because there is no way he's buying back. And you know TTD will just rotate themselves in towards that middle lane. They will take that third tower very quickly. And third Rax, and there's your buyback.
I was gonna say, they have buyback. On Chaos Knight, at least.
Yeah. They probably realize he also can't... He cannot fight without having that extra help. So Bear is the only thing he could try and kill. 3 seconds on the stun. And Mag even comes in just to, like, intimidate him back into the base again. But they've now got split Raxes down and a full Abyssal Blade that's up on Mag. He put everything on himself. Everything on himself because the bear is on cooldown. So they initiated on the bear. It's going to be a lot easier to kill that bear too, but Mag, he's using himself as a distraction. Nice back, nice wall. Big quad bolting, but the ship is hit so damn hard. Envy gets the Phantasm off, but he's still going to go down here, and GG is the call. The last two will help to kill up Bone 7. It seems we are destined to have two best of threes tonight.
Apparently, long day. But this is, makes for exciting Dota. TDD. Game one was always in the favor of Kaipi, I feel. I think the opposite was true of game two. That TTD from the drafting phase had addressed the Wisp and executed really, really well.
Yeah.
So I'm excited for game three.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it too, guys. So stay tuned. Short break and we come back. Remember, we still will have the 1v1 challenge at the conclusion of the grand final, which will happen obviously at the end of the next game because only best of three, only three games to play. So make sure you stay tuned for that one. If you have actually got yourself signed up for it, check your emails over the course of the next match because you will be getting a password to come into the private lobby, which will be made to play up against me for one of the Forest FS 2333 monitors. I always say 22, it's 2333. Yeah, that little sucker. We'll see you guys shortly. Game three.